Hello, my lovely viewers. Welcome to another video of Sports on Forzan Harun channel. And in this video, I'm going to review the Chelsea Burnley game at the Turf Moor Stadium in the EPL 7th week encounter of the 2020-21 season. And if this happens to be your first time of joining me on this show, please do well to touch the subscribe button and touch the notification bell so that whenever any program is uploaded or the channel goes live, you are going to be alerted. And then give me thumbs up if you enjoy the presentation. Most importantly, share the program for others to also join in the celebration of the Forzan Harun community. And do let me know in the comment box about your questions and contributions towards the video. And as you are all aware, it was a fantastic weekend for Chelsea team and the fans, as well as we thrashed Burnley by 3-0. And most importantly, I must admit, my prediction was spot on. My prediction was spot on because I predicted 3-0, and I even went ahead to give the goal scorers Timo Werner, Pulisic and Hakim Ziyech. But unfortunately, Pulisic during the warm-up got injured, and so his goal was taken by Zuma. It was same 3-0, but Pulisic didn't play because he had a little hamstring during the warm-up to the game, and his goal was taken by Zuma. So I was spot on in my prediction. I had the prediction 3-0, and I gave the names of those who were going to score the goals, bar Pulisic, because of the hamstring injury he suffered at the last minute before kick-off. And so this is important for those of you who are interested in going to the other aspect, business and betting aspect of the game. But be that as it may, that one is your own decision for you to make. And it highlights the importance and accuracy of the analysis of the videos and shows that we do here on this channel to get the predictions spot on, and then go ahead to give the names of the players who might possibly get the scores. The goals was a fantastic thing to do. I wouldn't want to praise myself. Let's move on. And obviously, this is one of the best, this is, I will say, the best performance of Chelsea the whole season so far. And I do agree with some pundits who are saying it's the best performance of Chelsea so far in the season, because we had, I think, 11 shots on shots, and then 8 shots on target. Quite fantastic. This is a team that even do not play shots on target sometimes. Remember in the game against Manchester United, we had only 1 shot on target. And so if in this game we had 8 shots on target, that tells you the level of accuracy with respect to precision and movement of play that the players put up on the day. And I must say, Lampard put out a selection which was a gamble, and it worked to perfection. And that is one thing with coaching. Sometimes you gamble with lineup and it works. And if it doesn't work, it didn't work, we would have lambasted him, honestly. So I must say kudos to Frank Lampard for having confidence in deploying this kind of lineup to play Mason Mount in the box-to-box midfield position, and N'Golo Kante holding in the midfield was quite fantastic. And Mason Mount has taken a claim for a position in that side of the field, the box-to-box midfield position. And then this is a time for Jorginho to be taking a seat on the bench calmly, because if Mason Mount can play in the midfield better, and even honestly last season he was playing in the middle better, and this season Frank Lampard was trying to tinker with his position by trying to falsely get him selected by putting him on the wings whilst allowing Jorginho to be in midfield. During my preview, remember, I selected Kovacic to have played in that role, and Frank Lampard deployed Mason Mount, who was equally good there. And I'm a fan of box-to-box midfield. And you know that was why I'm even calling for Tomori to add up to the midfield, because our midfielders were not functioning to light. But in this game, Mason Mount, Kai Havertz, and then N'Golo Kante were spot on. And so going forward, Frank Lampard might want to maybe continue to solidify that confidence within this line setup of midfield. And then The game, as you are aware, and Mount was aggressive and excellent in midfield with respect to his passing and then distribution. And also, Benjamin Mendy, the Super Mendy as I call him, had another clean sheet added to his record once again. And then let me quickly give you my ratings. My ratings is that I give positive to Silva, Hakim Ziyech is man of the match. And kudos, congratulations to Hakim Ziyech for scoring his first goal in the Premier League. I remember the last time he did it in the Champions League when he started. So he's the second player, I think, after Diego Costa to score in their first two starts for Chelsea. So congratulations to Hakim Ziyech, and more grease to his elbows. So hopefully much more better performances will be coming ahead of us. And then also I give Mendy positive, Mason Mount positive, Werner positive, Zuma positive, N'Golo Kante positive. You can see that when most of the players are rated positive, it means we won the game excellently. That's why they are getting the positive. And average, I give to Reece James, Chilwell, Havertz, and then Abraham. Nobody got negative. Negative is a below par performance, of course, as you are aware. And I used to watching my videos. And so, quite ironically, most of the players got positives as well as average. So let me do some screen display here. And remember, this subscriber challenge is still ongoing. If you've not subscribed to the channel, please do well to subscribe to the channel. It's free. I still repeat, it's free. It doesn't cost anything. Just subscribe to the channel. It's free. As I tell you, the Forzan Productions have put up massive investment in setting up the studio, the equipment and machinery to bring you the video. So what you have to do as a token for the channel is to subscribe and watch the channel if you are a sports fan. Okay. Let's do some little bit of screen display. So you see the scoreline boldly written there, 3-0 for Chelsea, highlighting Hakim Ziyech smiling there. So this is 3-1. You see the yards there, in short, 3-1. Timo Werner's goal, all the goal scorers, Kurt Zouma, Timo Werner, and Abdul Hakim Ziyech. All of them there, the 3-1, all the three goal scorers there. So that's the match there, Ziyech, Zouma, and Werner, the goal scorers there. Beautiful picture, the Mason Mount and Hakim Ziyech. Timo Werner running to celebrate his third goal. Zouma celebrating his second goal. Hakim Ziyech celebrating the first goal. That's Hakim Ziyech. How he dummied and expertly converted with his left foot to drill past Nick Pope. Nick Pope dived through the opposite end of the ball. That shows you how accurate Hakim Ziyech is. So that's the celebration there for you, the Chelsea players there. The celebration there for you. So we had a fantastic weekend as Chelsea fans, and hopefully many more of these performances will be coming as the seasonal games come in. More games do pile up as in the days ahead. And so, and also Frank Lampard, I will congratulate him, as I said earlier on. If he had had the tactics wrong, we would have criticized him. And so, congratulations to Frank Lampard for deploying these tactics and having the confidence in his players. And moving forward, Jorginho should take a seat on the bench. And still, we would love to still see more of Olivier Giroud. Olivier Giroud came into the game and scored a goal, but was disallowed. But we would love to see more of Olivier Giroud in the days ahead. And also, Kovacic, and also some of the players. You can see the strength in depth of Chelsea. Even Timo Werner was supposed to be on the bench while Christian Pulisic during warm-up unfortunately had a little bit of hamstring. And as I told you, Christian Pulisic, the fragile nature of Christian Pulisic is coming to play once again. Let's hope it's not anything serious, as Lampard has said. It's not anything serious, but considering the player in question, you have to pray very hard for him to bounce back strongly, because the season has just gotten underway. And so we can't afford to be missing Christian Pulisic, unfortunately, as a result of these injuries that keeps on coming up here and there. We wish Christian Pulisic speedy recovery in the days ahead. And also, very soon, I'm planning on doing something on, I will leave it as a surprise. So the subscriber challenge, as I said, is still on. Please do watch, subscribe to the channel. Thank you very much for engaging with me on this in this video. Hopefully, we are going to meet in my subsequent videos. Cheers, and I love you wherever you are. Enjoy the show and keep on sharing the good news. And most importantly, share the news for others to also join in the Fawzan Harun community. Cheers, and thank you for watching the show. Bye-bye.